Hello students, let's start exercise 9.1 question number 2. Write 4 more rational numbers in each of the following patterns. Okay, in each of the following pattern. Now see what pattern it is given. Minus 3 upon 5, minus 6 upon 10, minus 9 upon 15, minus 12 upon 20. If you observe this pattern, see. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12. Means it is multiplied. Yes? See, 5 ones same, similarly. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20. Means it is multiplied for numerator and denominator with the same number. Okay? And we have to find, write 4 more rational numbers. So, 4 more rational numbers we have to find. See, now I will show you. Minus 3 upon 5. How we got minus 6 upon 10? If we multiply by 2 for numerator and for denominator, what we'll get? Minus 6 upon 10. What we got? Minus 6 upon 10 we got. Okay. For minus 3 upon 5, we multiplied by, now see, with which number? 3. Then we got minus 9 upon 15. Okay, 3 threes are 9. One number is negative, another number is positive. So their product is negative. 5 threes are 15. Then minus 3 upon 5 into, see, we can do that like this also. Multiplied by, see, my, here we multiply by 3. Now, with which number we will multiply? 4. For numerator and denominator. So 3 fours are 12. Okay, so what we got answer here? Minus 12, why? Because see, one number is negative, another number is positive. So their product will be the negative. So 5 fours are 20. Okay. So we got these fractions after multiplying by 2. Then here after multiplying by 3. Then here after multiplying by 4. So what this pattern will be continued. So given fraction is minus 3 upon 5. Now what with which number we will multiply? Multiplied by 5. Okay. So 3 5s are 15, one number is negative, another number is positive, so their product will be the negative. 5 5s are 25. Okay, then next, now with which number we will multiply? For minus 3 upon 5, here we multiply by 5, now here we are going to multiply by 6. Okay, so minus 3 into 6, 3 6s are 18. First do like simple multiplication and then think for a sign. What we will do? One number is negative, another number is positive. So their product will be the negative. Okay. 5, 6 are 30. Okay. Then next. Minus 3 upon 5. Now with which number we will multiply? See, here we multiply by 6. Here we will multiply by 7. 3, 7s are 21. Okay, one number is negative, another number is positive, so their product will be the negative. 5 sevens are 35. Okay, how many rational numbers we got? 1, 2, 3. So still one more we need to find. So minus 3 upon 5. Here we multiply by 7, now here we will multiply by 8. Okay, so 8 threes are 24. Okay, one number is negative, another number is positive, so their product will be the negative. 8 5s are 40. So we got 4 more rational numbers. See, up till here it is given. They have given the pattern and we have to find 4 more rational numbers. So understood this pattern. First number, see, it is multiplied by 1 only. So 3 minus 3 upon 5. Multiplied by 2 here, multiplied by 3 here, multiplied by 4 for numerator and denominator. So we continue the pattern. Okay. So now see, solve next two examples. Again we are going to see these also pattern. Okay. So minus 1 upon 4. How we will get minus 2 upon 8 if we multiply by 2? See, 1 2s are 2. See, 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 3s are 3. Okay, same, 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12. Means it is multiplied. Okay, so for minus 1 upon 4, if we will multiply by 2 for numerator and for denominator, what will you get the answer? Minus 2 upon 8. Okay, 2 1s are 2 and it is negative. Okay, 4 2s are 8. Then again, minus 1 upon 4. So we got got put minus 2 upon it. Now here we will multiply by 3. So 3 ones are 3, one number is negative, another number is positive, so their product will be the negative 4. 3s are 12. Okay, then next, minus 1 upon 4. Now here we multiply by 3. Now with which number we will multiply? 4. 4 numerator and denominator. So 4 ones are 4, one number is negative, another number is positive, so their product will be the negative 4. 4s are 16. Okay, then minus 1 upon 4 into, now we will multiply by 5 for numerator and denominator, both of them. So 5 ones are 5. One number is negative, another number is positive, so their product will be the negative. 5 fours are 20. Okay, so still we have to find rational numbers. Minus 1 upon 4. Now here we, which number we will multiply? We will multiply by 6 in pattern. 2, 3, 4, 5. So 6. Multiply by 6. Okay. So 1 6 are 6. Here it will be the negative sign. 6 4 are 24. Okay. Then minus 1 upon 4. Multiply by now 7. Everyone understood pattern? 7 1 are 7. Minus 7 will come, because here one number is negative, this number is positive, so their product will be the negative. 4 7s are 28. So these are the 4 more rational numbers. Okay, see, follow the pattern and find 4 more rational numbers. Let's solve question number 3. Give 4 rational numbers equivalent to. We have to find equivalent rational numbers. So we were finding the equivalent fractions. Same way we have to find the equivalent rational numbers. Means we have to multiply for numerator and denominator by same non-zero number. Okay, or same non-zero integer. Okay, now given fraction is minus 2 upon 7. So find equivalent rational numbers. So if we will multiply by 2, for numerator, we have to multiply by 2. For the denominator also, means for numerator and denominator, we have to multiply by 2. Okay, so what we will get the answer? Minus 4 upon, okay, 7 2s are 14, 2 2s are 4. See, one number is negative, another number is positive, their product will be the negative. Okay, and how many rational numbers it tells us? 4 rational numbers. So still we can find. Minus 2 upon 7 is given rational number. Now here we multiply by 2, here we multiply by 3 for denominator and numerator. Okay. For numerator and denominator. 3 2s are 6. See, what answer we get? Minus 6. Okay. 7 3s are 21. Okay. So minus 2 upon 7. Now here we multiply by 3. Here we will multiply by 4. To get rational number, what? To get equivalent rational number, what we have to do? With which number we are multiplying for numerator? With the same number we have to multiply to the denominator. So we will get the equivalent rational number. Okay. So here we will multiply by 4 for numerator and for denominator. Okay. So what we will get? 2 4s are 8. It is here negative, this number is positive, so product will be the negative. 7 4s are 28. Okay, so 4 we have to find, now we will find minus 2 upon 7. So now here we multiply by 4, here we will multiply by 5. See, you can write 6 also, no problem, you can multiply by 6 also. But for numerator and denominator, you have to multiply with same number. You can take 7 also. You can take 8 also, but for numerator and denominator with same number we have to multiply. Whatever number you will take, with that number you have to multiply for numerator as well as denominator. Okay, so minus 2 into 5. 5 2s are 10, one number is negative, another number is positive, so their product will be the negative. Okay, so minus 10, 7 5s are 35. Okay, so Lord, these are the equivalent rational number to the given rational numbers. Okay, so minus 2 upon 7, then next is minus 4 upon 14, then next is minus 6 upon 21, next is minus 8 upon 28. And after that minus 10 upon 35. So these are the equivalent rational numbers to the given rational number. Okay. Solve for second one. Okay. So 5 upon minus 3. 5 upon minus 3 is given rational number. Same way. Same this way only we have to find for these also. So with which number we will multiply for numerator and denominator? With 2 we will multiply. Okay. So multiply by 2. Multiply by 2 for numerator and denominator. Okay. So what we will get the answer? 5 2s are 10. 3 2s are 6. Here it is negative and this number is positive. So their product will be the negative. Okay. Then 5 upon minus 3 is given rational number. Now we have to multiply it for numerator and denominator by 3. Okay. To get equivalent rational number, what we have to do? With which number we are multiplying for numerator with the same number, we have to multiply for denominator also. So now 5 3s are 15. 3 3s are 9. See, one number is negative, this number is positive. So product will be the negative. Okay. So 5 upon minus 3 multiplied by, now we will multiply by 4. So 5 4s are 20 minus 3 into 4. See, 3 4s are 12. Here it is minus 7. See, one number is negative, another number is positive. So their product will be the negative. Next number 5 upon x number 5 upon minus 3. Now with which number we will multiply here? By 5. Okay, multiply by 5 for numerator and denominator. 5 5s are 25. 3 5s are 50. 4 answer negative 7. So these are the rational numbers, equivalent rational numbers to the given rational number. So it is not like that whatever I have given that only you can use. So you can multiply by 6 also for numerator and denominator. You can multiply by 7 also for numerator and denominator to get equivalent rational number. Only what care you have to take with the same number. See, if you are multiplying for numerator by 7 with the same number, with 7 only you have to multiply for the denominator. So then only you are going to get the rational number equivalent to the given rational number. Okay, what I said, the number which you are multiplying for numerator with the same number you have to multiply for the denominator. Suppose here you are multiplying for 5 upon minus 3. If you are multiplying by 8 for numerator, then with 8 only you have to multiply for the denominator also. So you are going to get the equivalent rational numbers. Okay. So you can find your own also. Solve question number 4. Draw the number line and represent the following rational numbers on it. Now see, these rational numbers we have to represent on the number line. Already I have one here, one number line. And we have to represent 3, 4 on this number line. This is 3, 4. 3 upon 4. 3 upon 4. So what we will do? 0 to 1. We have to make how many equal parts? See, denominator is 4. So 0 to 1 we have to make 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. This fourth one part is? Okay? 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 equal parts we have to make. Means whatever denominator is there, that much equal parts we have to make between that two numbers. Okay? You can make here also. Actually no need, but you can make here also. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 equal parts. Okay. So 4 equal parts we have done. So 0 to 1. Okay. So this number is 0 integer 1 upon 4. This line is 0 integer 1 upon 4. This C. 0 integer 1 upon 4. Means what it is? 1 fourth. Means what it is? 1 fourth. This line is 0 integer 2 upon 4. 2, 4, this line is 0 integer 3 upon 4 and this line is 4 upon 4. Okay, means this is whole, means this is whole, means this is whole number. Okay, so this is whole number or not? 4 upon 4 means 1 and what we have to show? 3, 4. So which number will come on this number line 3, 4? See, this line will come on number line 3, 4. This line represents this third line, represent 3, 4. Understood everyone? This line represents 3, 4. See, if you will see what you have to do, whatever given fraction. See, 3 upon 4 is given number. So denominator is 4. So in each numbers between we have to make 4 equal parts. See, now you will ask me why you have not done here. See, here it is no negative sign. Now, so obviously this number will come to the right hand side of this 0. So I started making equal parts, 4 equal parts between 0 to 1, 4 equal parts between 1 to 2, 4 equal parts you can make between 2 to 3. But now only what we want, 3/4. 3/4 means, see, this is 1/4 line, this is 2/4, this is 3/4. So where it is, see. So, see, 0, it is here 0, this first line means 1/4, this second line means 2/4, this third line means 3/4, this line is 3/4, okay, and this is 4/4, 4/4 means only 1, 4/4, if you will do the reduction, you will get 1, so draw the number like and represent for a following rational number on it, so this is the 3/4, this number, this line represent 3/4. Okay. Now let's solve next one. -7/4. -7/4. Now what we can do for this to understand? See, -7/4. Now this number will come where? It will come on the number line. It is negative. So this number will come to the this side. Okay. Left hand side of the 0. Okay. This number will come left side, left hand side of the 0. Okay. So what we can do? 4 equal parts. Now see here. Denominator is 4. What is denominator? 4. So make 4 equal parts between them. See. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 4th part. Okay. 4. Again here also we are going to make same. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 4 equal parts. Then again we can make here also. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now -7/4. Now this part is -1/4. Yes, this is 0. It will first line is -1/4. Second line is -2/4. Third line is -3/4. And this means -4/4. See, I will show. See, what we have to show -7/4 on the number line. So what we did, 0 to 1, 4 equal parts we did, -1 to -2, 4 equal parts we did, -2 to -3, 4 equal parts we did. Okay, so 4 equal parts we did. Now this first part is -1/4. Why 4? Because we have made 4 equal parts. Okay, then it is -2/4, second line is -2/4, this is -3/4, okay, and this is -4/4. -4/4 means only -1. See, if you will do the reduction, what you are going to get? -1. Okay, now next, this fraction will come -5/4. See, this line will come -5/4. This line will come -6/4 and this line will come -7/4. So where it represent -7/4 on the number line, it will represent here. And this line is -8/4. -8/4 means only -2. See, -8/4. If you will do the reduction, 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So -2 you got. So where it represent on the number line? Here. So -7/4. Where it represent on the number line? Here. So this is -7/4. So question number 5. The points P, Q, R, S, T, U, A and B on the number line. See. P, Q, R, S, T, U, A, B are on the number line. Are such that TR is equal to RS is equal to SU. Means this, it is equal. Means it has equal distance. Okay. And AP is equal to PQ is equal to QB. Means this distance is equal. Okay. So name the rational numbers represented by P, Q, R, S. Means C. This P represent which rational number on the number line? Q represent which rational number on the number line? R represent which rational number on the number line? S represent which rational number on the number line? That we have to find. Now see, if you will see, here it has shown many equal parts of this line? 1, 2, 3. See, 1, 2, 3. 3 equal parts as drawn on the number line. Okay, so now we will make 4 remaining numbers also. To get this answer, we will make 3 equal parts for between each number. Okay, so 0, 2, 1. Also, we will make 3 equal parts. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 3 equal parts we did. Then 1, 2, 2 also we will make 2, 3 equal parts. 3 equal parts we did. Okay, same way here also we will do. 1, 2, this part is third part, means where the minus 1, it is third part. See, 1, 2, 3, 1 where it is, that is third part. 1, 2, 3, where it is 2, third part. 1, 2, 3, so we need the 3 equal parts. Now what, this number it shows on the number line, 1 upon 3. Okay, this line, see, after 0, this first line, it shows on the number line 1 upon 3. Because, why 1 upon 3? See, it has made between 0 and 1 how many equal parts? 3 equal parts, okay? 1 third, this is 2 upon 3, okay? And this third line means, it is given 1. 1 means 3 upon 3. 3 upon 3 means only 1, okay? So, this line it represent 4 upon 3. This line it will come 4 upon 3, okay, this line, 4 upon 3, this line it will come 5 upon 3, then this number it represent 6 upon 3, 6 upon 3 means only 2, see if we will do the reduced term for 6 upon 3, you are going to get 2, okay, then P represent 7 upon 3 on the number line, so it has asked P. So, P represents 7 upon 3 on the number line. See, P represent 7 upon 3. P represents 7 upon 3 on the number line. Then it is asked Q also. Now, P is 7 upon 3. Then Q, 8 upon 3. See, what we did, 0, 2, 1. We did 3 equal parts. Why we did 3 equal parts? See, because between 2 and 3 it was 3 equal parts. So, we did here also 3 equal parts. Here also 3 equal parts. This side also we did the 3 equal parts. And then we started writing the number. We did 3 equal parts. So, first line is 1 third. Second is 2 third. And third is 3 upon 3 means 1. Fourth line is 4 upon 3. Fifth line is 5 upon 3. Sixth line is 6 upon 3 means only 2. Okay. Then seventh line is 7 upon 3. Then Q represent 8 upon 3. And B represent 9 upon 3. 9 upon 3 means only 3. Understood? 9 upon 3 means only 3. See, if you will do the reduced term for 9 upon 3, you are going to get 3. So, Q represent 8 upon 3 on the number line. Understood? Q represent 8 upon 3 on the number line. See, for your understanding, I will write this again. Okay? So, now this sentence. Now this is 0. 3 equal parts between 0 to minus 1. So, first line is minus 1 upon 3. Second line is minus 2 upon 3. And third it is minus 3 upon 3. Minus 3 upon 3 means only minus 1. If you will do the reduced term for minus 3 upon 3, you are going to get minus 1 answer. Okay. So now, this is minus 3 upon 3. So this line is, R is minus 4 upon 3. Then S is minus 5 upon 3. Okay. So now it is as R and S also. So R represent, R represent minus 4 upon 3 on the number line. Okay, R represent minus 4 upon 3 on the number line. Then next, S. S represent minus 5 upon 3 on the number line.